Hey guys, what is going on? Chris here with Shughead Gaming, bringing you my review for Ace Combat 7 Skies Unknown, developed by Bandai Namco and released January 18th, 2019 on PS4, Xbox One, PC, and exclusively in VR for PSVR. This is selling for an estimated price of $60, and of course that depends on your region. And as usual, this game was reviewed on the PS4 Pro, and for this review, I will only be covering the VR portion because that's what we do here at Shughead Gaming, and honestly, fanboyism aside, after playing this in VR and then jumping into the standard version, I just couldn't play it that way, so stay tuned and I'll tell you why. Become an ace pilot and soar through photorealistic skies in full VR. Down enemy aircraft and experience the thrill of engaging in realistic dogfights. Ace Combat 7 Skies Unknown has easily been one of the most anticipated PSVR games since it was mentioned years ago, but with reduced content in the final build, is it still worth strapping in for? Let's find out. As always guys, if you like this video, please hit that like button, and if you'd like to see more PSVR content from me, please consider subscribing, and for video updates, hit that bell icon. Let's start this review off with a look at graphics. Well, holy crap, I don't even know what to say. Just damn. Ace Combat is so graphically impressive when in flight that everything else on PSVR is a distant second. As per usual for this series, when you are close to the ground, the textures are less than impressive, but they're the exact same in the flat version. However, since this is a flying game, you rarely spend much time looking closely at the ground, and if you are, you're likely on fire. So with that out of the way, let's talk about the flying part. Nothing, and I mean nothing, on PSVR has prepared you for the pure immersion of sitting in your cockpit at 35,000 feet. The cockpit is very sharp and on par with what we saw in GT Sport. All the instruments are active and reflect real-time flight data. There's no game HUD, so all your info will actually come from the cockpit displays and your heads up. The entire plane inside and out is fantastically detailed and incredibly impressive when looking over your shoulder back over your wings. The Top Gun vibes are real here, but more on that later. Special mention has to go to the sensation of having the canopy visibly above your head. The sense of actually being inside is undescribable and becomes mind-blowing when breaking through cloud cover and watching the canopy drip with condensation or reflecting the revealed sun rays. The sense of height and speed is incredible here, and I am overjoyed to tell you that nothing was nerfed in the translation to VR to make it more comfortable for the masses. When taking off from either the runway or aircraft carrier, some jagged edges and slightly blurred textures can be seen, but again, once up in the air, draw distance is incredible and everything looks as sharp as you can expect from this headset. Literally, when jumping back and forth between the flat version and the VR version, it is incredible how much of this AAA game has been retained when coming to VR. Lighting effects, explosion effects, jet stream, and missile trails all come out to play, and when combined with the weather effects, Ace Combat is mind-blowingly impressive and the showstopper for PSVR. This is a full-on VR orgy for the senses, and it holds nothing back. And that brings us to sound. Again, incredible. Ace Combat 7 Skies Unknown is a masterpiece in 3D audio design. Developed by a separate team than the flat version, the immersive audio experience when playing in VR with a good set of headphones is reference quality VR perfection. The flat version is incredible, don't get me wrong, but the dynamic effect of being surrounded by the sounds of a jet fighter are amazing. The sound of the afterburners lighting up, the buffeting of turbulence when dropping through cloud cover, or the screaming effect of an enemy jet literally soaring over your head is just amazing, and the culminating effect is almost impossible to explain to someone. Everything here, sound effects and voice work wise, is top notch, authentic and dynamic. The music? Not so much. If you're familiar with the series, it's the same Japanese action score that's been a staple of the series. It has its fans, but for many, I think the desired choice will be turning it off and the sound effects up, or in my case, Spotify, with the Top Gun soundtrack on. Gameplay is up next. As a Simcade experience, the Ace Combat series has in the past and here in the 7th entry retained a level of approachability. This isn't a hardcore flight sim and it doesn't try to be. But when flying on expert controls and with a high difficulty setting, Ace Combat 7 is no walk in the park and should offer a challenge even to veterans of the series. Easy controls have left and right and up and down on the left analog stick and makes turning as simple as pushing left and right. Expert controls are where most players will find themselves and sees the plane rolling left and right and requiring a pull down on the stick to then pull in that direction, with rudder controls on the bumpers. Controls are made substantially more realistic and difficult by using a supported HOTAS flight stick, but are immensely fun and immersive. Planes are responsive and forgiving, but at the same time still manage to feel realistic, weighty, and affected by gravity and wind speed. The VR mode sees a selection of unlockable armaments and planes, which can be unlocked through continued VR play. And this brings me to the big elephant in the room, the lack of content. Originally planned and announced to be the complete game in VR, Bandai Namco were unprepared for the graphical limitations of bringing their game to PSVR. Much like GT Sport, the graphical downgrades required and most likely the economics of bringing it fully into VR were most likely too great, and as such we are left with more of a sample of what may come to PSVR 2. What we are left with is single player, three complete missions including landing and taking off, a free flight mode, and some extras like a flight show mode and the ability to view planes up close in the hangar. Some may blow through the three missions in an hour, but on high difficulty, the last two missions weren't easy, and completion of the VR campaign was about 2.5 hours. For me, the lack of content is disappointing, but honestly, flying is flying. The different environments would be nice, but when playing past entries in the series, dogfighting above the clouds and shooting ground-based targets can only be so diverse. So for me, it's the experience that I'm after rather than the amount of missions. I just want to fly in VR. And Ace Combat 7 Skies Unknown really, really delivers in that regard. Flying above the clouds and looking out over the canopy felt real. It wasn't kinda cool and gimmicky, it felt real. The feeling of dogfighting up and down through the clouds, twisting and turning up and down until it didn't matter, simply defy explanation with words. This makes the Star Wars Battlefront VR mission feel like playing in the kiddie pool in comparison. Ace Combat, despite its VR intensity, left me feeling great during my almost 3-hour play session. However, know going in that this game has no comfort options and compromises nothing. So for those with weak VR legs, you have been warned. Ace Combat 7 is played seated and is controlled with either a DS4 or can be played alternatively with a PS4 compatible flight stick by Hori or Thrustmaster. See the notes below for specifics. And finally, that brings me to Fun Factor and my final review. Ace Combat 7 Skies Unknown in VR is easily in the top 3 VR experiences I've ever had. Everything about the game, from the visuals and sound design to the gameplay, is fun and incredibly immersive. I hate number ratings and instead rate games on the basis of buy, wait for a sale, or burn it to the ground. So this is incredibly hard, as there isn't a lot of VR content, and if, like me, that's all you care about, the asking price can be a bit steep. Really, what it comes down to is what the value of the content is to you. For me, I look at this as one of the greatest video game experiences I've ever had, and I plan to return to it over and over just to fly in VR, as well as being my go-to demo game for others. Many would gladly pay $25 for an awesome 10-minute arcade experience, so that gives me some perspective as well. Like I said, it comes down to the value to you. If you simply want to beat the game and move on, this is a pricey buy and better left for a sale. But if you're like me and the experience is more important than the content, it's worth it. Anyways guys, if you like this video, please hit that like button. And if you'd like to see more PSVR content from me, please consider subscribing. And for video updates, hit that bell icon. And remember, if you want to see more PSVR news and info, check Shughead Gaming out on Twitter and Facebook. I will catch you guys on my next video.
I feel the need for speed.